to give you some, yeah, to give you some idea on some important logs how we are going to analyze. Okay, so with that, let us start. Yeah, okay. So after yesterday, I started collecting the logs from various sources. Predominantly, I have launched three VMs. One is Kali Linux, and another one is a Windows machine where my what do you say the logs that are related to. Oh, I mean, like in a VM, I have installed one Windows, and from there I have collected it. And one more thing is the system where I have installed the Splunk Enterprise itself, the host machine, the main machine. Okay, on that also I have installed the forwarder and started collecting this particular what whichever you are seeing now, right? That particular machine's logs as well. Okay. So now let us see. So you know that all the logs will be going to get stored in which location? It will be in main location. If you are collecting it from various sources, okay, just click on that main. Okay. So if you see this, okay, I have 24 hours of this thing. Let me change it to all time, or if I say it. Okay. Yes. Okay. If you click on the host, okay, you see like you are able to see only Kali and Splunk, means my Windows machine in the VM, which I've yesterday I was showing you guys like how to install the forwarder, right, in a VM Windows environment. That is this machine, and I have a Linux machine to also to be there to collect. But interestingly, what I found is if I say like this star, okay, give star anything, okay, I got totally three machines, okay, Kali Linux stuff, and this as well, okay. But the source, whichever I have, right, you'll be getting the different kinds of logs. From where you are getting the logs, say from the my Kali Linux machine is the only Linux machine what I have got. So from there, all syslogs, like the packages logs, like installation and setup kind of thing. This is okay. All those logs and so those machine logs, the daemons which are running on my machine, okay, are coming over on these particular sources. But you see this Windows event log security, all these things, these are the actual Windows logs, guys. I like, once if you get the logs onto your machine, there should be a way where how you can actually understand these logs, means which events you have to get. Okay, say for example, I want to know some failure logs related thing. For that, usually what you can do is before you write the correlation rules, or you are just trying yourself, you doesn't know like how to get those things. Okay, so what do you do? What you do? Okay, I suggest that you have to go to event codes if it is in Windows machine. Okay, say for example, okay, let me check. This I'll give main. Okay, let me put it as main. Okay, I'll get. Okay, I have. So in this particular machine, okay, I have Splunk, which is the which host is my Windows VM where I have installed the forwarder. Okay, in that particular thing, you will be getting the logs like this. Okay, all the logs will be like this. If you install the same forwarder on Windows server or Windows machine, anything, irrespective of anything, okay, you'll be getting the logs like this. But how I'll come to know that which logs I have to monitor, okay, which logs I have to take into consideration, because some things are just updating some information on like what happened in your system, like that, okay, which are not critical at all. But you have to know which logs to be like used for what purpose. So you should start reading them first. So where you will get that information? Let me check. I think I have bookmarked it. Bookmark. Not this, not this. Okay. Okay, you do one thing. Windows. Okay. Event IDs. You just give this. Okay. There'll be the first link you will get, Windows Security Logs Encyclopedia. Okay, just click on that. Okay, now you got the complete source where you can understand the Windows logs. Okay, Windows, different types of Windows logs. What is Windows event IDs? Event ID means there should be some way of identifying an action happened in your Windows machine. Okay, for that Windows, what they have done, if you are changing a password, okay, you then once that happens, okay, or once that attempt happens, okay, a specific event code is get generated. If it is successful, one specific event code is generated. If it is failure, one event code is generated. If someone has installed something in their machine, one event code is generated. Someone deleted a file, one event code is generated. Because whatever you do, it all linked to the event codes. Means the logs will get recorded event code as a base. Okay. So now if you see this particular thing, okay, if I put it as raw, will it be helpful for you? Yeah. This is the event log which I have received from the system. Okay, in this particular thing, I found 4624. I don't know what is 4624. I'm very curious about that. Just go here, Control F, Control V. Special privileges assigned to new logon. Okay, because this special privileges might be when it will come and all. It is like for me, since it is a VM, so there might be something like that, some special privileges might be assigned. So similar way, I would like to show you some more. By just clicking on stats count, if you see this, event codes are automatically identified by our Splunk. I didn't give anything, event, what is event, what is event code, what is the ID, all these things I have not given, but this Splunk has actually noted it down. Okay, these are the different types of events it captured. So top 10 are these, okay, but still I want to know stats count by event code. Okay, now these are the activities that are happened in our machine like this. Okay, so few of them are like Windows 10, few of the event logs are not, might have not updated here, but all the criticals are already here, whichever it is very critical, right, are already here. Okay, so now I want to know, say for example, if I come here, what is 4608, because these are mostly like direct related to us. Control F, Control V. Windows is starting up, means when Windows has actually initiated, that time also a log is getting created. Okay, so for example, you know that a specific set of IP addresses you are monitoring are specific usernames, like you have just removed an employee, okay, there shouldn't be any access for that particular user, because all his IDs, whichever it is applicable, once he's moving out of the company on the day when he's moving out, okay, you are actually disabling his account. There could be a chance like few accounts, kind of your mail accounts or some other accounts or something like that, or some administrator might be there available only after 2 days. During that time only he should be able to come and disable that account, but you want to monitor the list continuously for the 2 days that next, like employees got released on Friday evening, but the admin will be gonna come on Monday, but till the 2 days, whether any you have told that employee not to log into the machine as you have officially relieved out of the duties and you don't have any privileges to, I mean, like you are not authorized to access the machine. So this intimation you have given, but still after going home, if the user is trying to log into the system, though that kind of means some kind of very narrow kind of thing, scenarios you want to monitor, this is very useful. If the Windows is actually this particular thing, okay, he's actually trying to log into his machine, like coming into the office, ID card is not disabled, he just came into the office and he sat and he started unlocking his starting his machine. And if there is any events like 4604 4608, and if the IP address of this the user ID is this, okay, and if this 4608 is happened and user login attempt, there will be one more ID. If that also happened, this and this, if three events, event code is equal to this, and event code is equal to this, and event code is equal to this, which is successfully logged in, so that time alert me, okay, to the SOC. So immediately they will contact the security, that this guy is security, means like physical security, who are the guards. Okay, this guy is actually got relieved, but I don't know how he came into the he's able to log into the system or something like that. This kind of like out of context scenarios can also be monitored in this. So to understand that, okay, it is like for you to slowly adapt which codes can be used for what purpose. That is the important thing. These are the codes that are just lying over there. They will be there to just help someone to understand what happened with the system. But how a security team uses them, it's all depends upon your capabilities, how you leverage those IDs. Okay, so now I have 4616. Let me check what it is. I'll go here. Okay, for the system time was changed. Yes, definitely. You might be seeing many times I'll be going and changing my system date and time. That has to be recorded, because there will be a chance that attackers, what they do is for if any attack happens, if someone is going to, like, you might be once the lateral movement happens, if they want to cover the tracks, what they do is they'll be trying to change the logs. Okay, how they do one among those different kinds of changing the logs is by changing the date and time of the logs that are getting generated on the machine. How it happens, when you change the date and time, definitely the log timings will get changed. He might be changing the date, he might be changing the time. So when you are trying to access when the attack has happened, he might have actually changed the date. So when he left, all these things, information, critical information, you might be losing it. You might be not looking at this right from the right point of view, where the attacker might have left or something like that. So for this kind of things, I want to monitor if some user, because if it is an admin, no one can actually change the date and time. Example I'm just giving. Okay, so if a system, okay, normal user, non-administrator, if a user is equal to not equal to an administrator, and okay, the event ID is equal to 4116. Okay, the system time changed. Okay, event code is equal to 4116. Okay, then raise an alert. Okay, how come he went to that particular location? Okay, how he was able to convert it? How he got escalated the privileges? Okay, the user is not normal user, but he escalated his privileges. How he has done that? Okay, so that kind of thing, it is very important for us. Okay, these things, why I am explaining is the only reason that you have to understand them. Now see this, this is 4624. What is 4624? It is very important code that you should remember. Okay, an account was successfully logged in means you have logged into the system successfully. Okay, so all your successful logins will be taken up here. Okay, so if there is when you are going to are you going to monitor the successful logins? Definitely, yes, we are going to log into the successful logins. How we are going to correlate with some kind of behavioral timings, like the timing is somewhere around night 11 o'clock, okay, and or say for example, forget about that, you don't have, earlier also I have given the same example, the IP address location is the source IP address location is from China, and the user is your own user, any user, user can be any user, but source is source IP address is from China, okay, and the user can be anyone, admin or normal user or anyone, okay, and the event ID is 4624. Okay, how come from China a user is trying to log into my system? When the request got generated, okay, when the request got generated, okay, a user who you, what you are doing is you are trying to, for the same instance of time, you are like the system is generating the logs from the network side, means like you are having source IP and destination IP, all these things will be there, right? There is one login request, like someone connection request came, okay, to your VDI, or VDI means like your virtual machine, someone is sitting somewhere, or remote access request came, okay, and the remote access request, they have given your source IP as your login, what do you say, system IP address as the when you click on start, if you do RDP, okay, you will get remote desktop connection, right? If you click on that, okay, you will get one IP address, that is computer IP address. When you give that particular computer address, if you want, I can show you this. Yeah. There we have this bumper offer, I guess. That, okay, it is working. Okay. So here, the user has given this particular IP address, okay, which is the system, my own system, which is there in office, okay, and he's trying to connect, okay. If any remote connection, okay, what is the remote connection? 8086 or something, correct, right? So that particular RDP port, okay, is having an IP address from China and trying to connect. So that time when you try to connect, first you will get the Windows, like you enter the username and password, right? When they give you, when that comes, if the username and password is perfect and the country is China, it is successful. But how come I don't have any users in China? Okay, any customers or my employees are not been to China, but how come I am getting a request from there? Okay, so that kind of things you can actually catch the adversaries, means adversaries means the attackers, okay, using this particular kind of what do you say, IDs in the Windows. We are going to discuss about some part of Linux also, but more full-fledgedly we will be discussing, but today I just want to give you for today and tomorrow morning for you to go through some material, okay, so that is the reason why I have taken this. Okay, so you have all different kinds of IDs. If someone is like say for example, let me check if I have any, because I tried from my this machine VM to I have done failed attempt logins. I don't know what is the reason the failed login attempts are not getting logged. Okay, event code is equal to, okay, let me check if I have any, at least one, that's what the issue. Okay, I'm not getting the failure login attempts in my machine. I don't know, in my virtual machine. Okay, let me check. At least anywhere, no, not even closer to that. index is equal to anywhere by any chance internal, by any chance, no chance at all. Let me give 1 minute. I will check whether my, yes, perfect. I'm getting those logs. I'm just selecting it. Let me check the source. Okay, source type. Okay. Okay, this is happening. Okay. Because what is this? This particular desktop means my host machine. I'm trying to see if there are any event codes are there or not. Unfortunately, I have not selected any application logs or anything. I have clicked on just this next, I guess. I haven't selected anything. That is the reason. Okay, but through VM, I don't know why I'm not getting the failure logins. But you remember that 464, any event, if you like someone is trying to log in, you will get this. But I seriously telling these many logs, it's very hard for me to like which are important logs and which are not important logs. It's very hard for me to remember. Okay, so is there any way that I can actually like just in a immediate pace I can jump in and then I see these logs are important, then I'll come here and I'll go through each one of them and then I'll understand. It's just a one line thing. Like if someone asks you what is 4624, you should say like an account is login is successful, correct, right? Okay, now I'll show you one more thing here. Go to
Sorry, Raghav. Yeah, I'm unable to see your screen actually. It's showing as a gray.
Okay, let me stop that RDP thing because I'm connecting on the RDP thing again. Let me open that. Today we have again same this issue. Meeting. Screen share. Let me reconnect again, guys. Let me reconnect again. Okay. Let us. Okay. Hey, now it is clear, right, for you guys? Hello? Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Okay.
Okay, fine. See, so if you go to this particular thing, you will get all the Windows related events. But similar way, Linux doesn't have. Okay, Linux, most of it has got PIDs and some kind of system messages. So you have to take the, you have to parse. Say, for example, let me check. I have the Kali Linux machine. This is main. Okay, all my and instead of Splunk as my host machine, means my VM, Kali Linux, I'll put Kali. Okay, this is the name I have given it to my machine, Kali Linux machine. I got these logs, and what I'll be doing is, okay, if I go here, say for example, fail, sorry, I am trying to search some kind of failure. Fail. Some failure things. Anything can be. Before or anything, like in a word or sentence, before or anything which is related to the fail, please give me that particular thing. If you come down, some kind of permission denied, okay, authentication, okay. I want to know, instead of this, authentication, some means login means authentication, right? Let me check if I have any such things. Okay, okay. See, this is some sort of authentication, start authentication, failure during the authentication. Correct, right? Okay. So what I'll do is, there are the logs that are related to the authentication failure. Got it, right? Okay. These are the authentication related failures. When I try to log into my machine, see here in this particular thing, this says that I haven't entered any username or password or anything. Okay. So when I tried to enter that, it showed me this error is something. And before to that, wantedly, I was logged in. Okay. Here it shows before to that, I was successfully logged in because I have entered my username and password successfully. I was playing around, like sometimes logging into the system and entering the wrong username and password, whether they are getting, what do you say, properly getting recorded or not, I was checking. Okay. So, if you see this, okay, in this particular thing, for Linux, it is very hard for us to, what do you say, create the logs, even the syslogs, there are like, they will immediately identify, like understand the logs, but they don't give you the 100% information on whether, like what is happening into the system. That is what the issue with the syslogs. Because you have so many number of variants, okay, maybe this is Kali logs, it might have not properly automatically identified the logs. So that's why I told you, if you are trying to create your own things, what you have to do this, you know, what is this, okay? So what you have to do, you have to select that, okay, whichever the portion, and you have to name your own this thing. What do you say? If you click on this, you want have something extract field, correct, right? That's what I have told you. You take it and you create a key value pair for that. Now I know that a specific log I will be taking, this log, okay, and I'm 100% sure that whenever I get the authentication failure, okay, this one, this is really equal to failed login. Okay. So like this, what I'll do is, I'll select rejects, okay, and do. But there is a better way to actually identify them. But for now, to practice from your sides, okay, I would request you to just. I would request someone. Yeah. Okay. Just your video is on. Whoever it is, request just to disable your video. Yeah, yours only. Yeah, your video is on. Okay, that's okay. Okay, so the field name, okay, you have to give like failed login. Okay, then you if you want, you can say like Kali or anything. Okay, and you just click extract. Okay, so now it has actually stored, and what it does is wherever that particular thing is there, okay, this particular thing, okay, it will try to identify that. Okay, now, so for now, what we'll do is we'll just go ahead with this particular thing, okay, and see what is the regex. If you want to modify that, you can do that. Okay, then what you can do is whether that is explicitly updated or not, you can check it, but not, you can go here, next. Okay, now, okay, it feels, okay, where it went, okay, explore the field just you have extracted. You will come over here. Okay. Now, so you will be getting all the, I think, yeah, where it went. No, this is not required. Source type, why it has come. Okay. Did we do anything wrong? I think we have to do it again. Select. Okay. Because that is the reason, two parameters, it is very important when it comes to like Linux related things. One is like this return value 7. Okay, this is and this one. Okay, and these things important, but for now, let me check only this. Okay, path failure. Okay, let me give this to this. Actually, this should be the correct one. Okay, but let me check this. Okay, authentication failure. Okay, path failure. Okay. You have created additional fields from your source light DM. Okay. So let it be light DM source. Okay, syslog, I have to take it, but I don't know why I have taken that. Okay, let it be. Explore more fields. Come here. Okay, come here. Search. Okay. Index. That's what I don't want to deviate. I thought of going ahead with Windows, but unfortunately, I came to Linux now I am stuck over here. Host is equal to Splunk. Okay, now it can be converted to the Kali. Okay, and okay, what is the ID? Let me check. authentication. Failure. Let it be anything over here. Before to that, let anything be there before to that. Okay, I don't have any issues with that. Authentication. Am I auth? Spelling wrong, guys? Did I? Okay, let me check. All time. Guys, any spelling mistake is there? Okay, authentication. Guys, am I audible first of all?
Yeah, Raghav.
Yes, Raghav.
Yeah. Okay, fine. Okay. If I go here like this, authentication, what I should be looking at is only these type of logs. Okay. See, I can go all these logs. These are additional logs. Okay. But what I want is light DM auth. But that's what I'm checking, where this particular field is there. I'm just to which key value pair it is linked. Okay. Easiest way is just click on that. Okay. And if you go to this particular where it is process, okay, copy it. Okay, that's count by, okay, the idea. Okay, wow, this hasn't gave us any valuable info, because even though if we have the failure logins, where it is this one. Okay, light DM colon authentication, that is, sorry. Okay, where it went. Okay, okay, give me that. No, this is not for us. Just give me a second, guys. Okay. Spunk server, time, user, version. Structured field is a string. This is a problem with the Linux. Why? I mean, like, you have to give the, you have to create your own this thing. What do you say? Okay, let me check. Okay, let me check this one. What I want is AUTH. Okay. Oh my god. Anywhere AUTH? No, this is not. Okay, PID. PID we will have definitely, but it is always not good to rely on only PID. Never rely on only single value. Okay, never ever rely on the single value. Okay, events with this field. Let me check all the events with this field. PID. Okay, I got this. PID is equal to 775. If you see PID, why you shouldn't relay is you got the same process ID, but the failure is the same, like authentication failure. You might be having multiple PIDs. If you go to some other failure login attempt where authentication is failure, yeah, this one, okay. Yeah, where authentication single line you will come to know, right? Okay, what I want is now just I want to show you guys extracting the failure. Windows, it's very easy for us. Okay, Linux, since we have so many variants, that's why Splunk you need to modify it. Okay. Authentication failure. How I do? Okay. User ID is like this. Admin is nothing but the super user is 1000. Authentication failure. I have this, but let me check more fields. What other things we can take it here? Login name is equal to empty. Username is equal to Rago. Okay. Actually, only this sudo auth. Okay. Let me take this. Put it over here. Then it will give me some sort of. Yeah. Perfect. Okay, now it has actually drilled down a lot of logs for us now. Okay, now in this I would like to take only the failure attempts like this. So then what I'll do, okay, I will take this particular thing. Okay, then I'll say then, okay, then it further narrowed, okay, how many times I have actually tried to tried to perform the failure attempts. And if you see this once again, okay, I will copy it, okay, and if I see this one only authentication failure, I'll be getting lot many logs for me. Okay, if you see few things which you will miss is there are some login attempts made with some user root. Okay, so those things you will be losing it. Okay, so you must specify like what kind of failures that you are trying to try to get. So some of them are these LDM authentication, some of them are sudo, okay, like this. Okay, so you have to specify that. Okay, if you have to specify this thing under one keyword, this thing under one keyword, means these two comes under the same keyword. Say for example, status code might be 400 and status code might be 500 status. Okay, similar way you have to put all these things under one keyword. Okay, so with that you can put those keywords into one list, and then you can start searching the logs based on that particular. We will do this thing in future in narrowing down of those logs, but for now I would request we'll go ahead with some information what I have decided to share with you guys on how we can actually take advantage of the logs, Windows logs. Okay, now but you might have come to know about it now, that how we can extract the how we can actually monitor the logs and all, but for now just go ahead with the Windows. You take same way I'll be giving you an easy way to get those logs maybe tomorrow or day after tomorrow. But now you just go ahead with the Windows things, okay? Where you can get the logs, all this information. You go to SOF ELK, okay? And just click enter, okay? You will get some GitHub, okay? You just click on that, okay? And go here, okay? Let me share that. These are not at all useful for us. Okay, someone has actually created some configuration files for their tools. The same thing we can actually use, leverage it, those which event IDs we have to monitor using this. If you have like routers, DNS, DHCP, what are the like SSH ID, how you which ports, if it is a Cisco, okay, Cisco, what things I have to monitor, okay. So all those things they have included in them. I have something called as Windows. Okay. Don't take the input configuration file. Go to Windows configuration. And just click on that. This code and all, everything is not required for us. Okay. The only thing what it required for us is note down all these codes and copy it to a notepad. Okay, like this. Okay, and just give some space like this. What are these codes? These codes are related to the login. Okay, so if someone is like, this is a 4634. Okay, let me check whether I have 4634 or not in my machine. Okay, I will take it as Plunk. Okay. Event code is equal to what is that? 4634 or 24? I don't even remember that. 4634. Because I think I have logged off once. 4634. No, I haven't. Okay, let it be. And now what I'll do is I'll take this particular log. Post is equal to Splunk. It should be case sensitive. Okay, and event code. If you are writing something query wrong, like instead of capital S, if you put small s, it doesn't give you any error because it will go and search and I didn't find that particular thing. Till whatever extent it has searched, that result it will give you. So better you have that particular kind of. So I have logged out of system a few times. So those are the logs. Like yesterday night after 10:30 p.m. I have logged out something. So another 24 p.m. I have logged them because of like system what do you say, ideal for some time it will automatically gets logged off, right? Might be those logs. Okay, and I forcefully have logged off this particular time. Okay, so what I say is, if you have to understand like different IDs, can you use this ID for some specific purpose? Say for example, a specific system which is related to the SOC team should never get logged off, okay? Because those should be like displaying all your big graphs and all to entire your security team in a contained zone, okay? If no one is there, if an attacker logs in and if that security machine itself gets compromised, means that means no one is there. It got logged off means there might be something fishy happening in your organization. So for that kind of monitoring thing, you might be using these kind of things. But just how to use them, it all depends upon you. But you have to know like what event is used for what. And 528. Okay. 528. it is not available here. Okay, so if you don't get any of information, because some of them are displaying for the log off or login happened or login failure happened, it specifically says, okay, whether it is a log for a Windows normal machine like user machine or it is a Windows server 2016 or 2019 or 2012 or something like that. Okay, so 528 event ID. Okay, so if you click on this, you will come to know that 528 is logged whenever an account logs on the local computer and your local machine. Okay, expects for it this thing. Okay, so just go through it and you have to learn the difference of what is 528, okay, and what is 540. Okay, if it is not available here directly, you go here and click on 540. Just see whether it can, from here also you will get it. If you are not getting on Google, but you can come over here. Here, if you won't get, go to Google. 550 successful network login. Network login means what? Your machine is there somewhere, okay, and you are trying to, your system administrator wants to access your hard disk. Okay, so what he'll do? He doesn't take the remote. What he'll do? He just want to access the file system. What he'll do, he'll go to his network place, correct, right, his network place, and he'll see whether your system is available for him to access or not. Then he'll select your system, then he'll click on login. Okay, that time he will be logging if with your credentials. Say example, you are only an system administration, you are a user. If someone is logging into a specific system with the network credentials, like through network with your own credentials, okay, or someone's their own credentials into your system, you might be logging into your system from somewhere, from other machine, or okay, an admin is trying to log into your machine. Okay, that time what happens is it will generate a successful, I mean, like successfully when he logins, it will be 540. There will be a relevant 540 through network. If someone is does a failed attempt, for that a failure event log will be there, network failure login attempt. Okay, those things are all available here. Okay, I would request all our successful logins are different types of successful logins are here, and different types of failure logins are here. Okay, these are, I think, these are failure logins. Okay, these are successful logins, and these are very critical things that you have to monitor. Say for example, 1056, I want to know what zero, why I have to 1056, it is not here, then I'll click 1056. Let me check if I'll get it or not. Okay, I didn't get anywhere here. So now what I'll do, event ID 1056. Okay, the DHCP server has detected it is running on a domain controller and no credentials configured for the for use with the dynamic DNS registry initially by the. See, there is a server like configured on your Windows server machine. Okay, there are many companies. The DHCP, what they do is they configure using the they configure it on your Linux. They can configure it on Linux. If they have the Windows servers, they have the license and everything, they'll be configuring DHCP from Windows machine itself. Okay. Now, if any specific such kind of machine doesn't have the credentials, login credential, anyone can just power on and they can actually log in and they can do some modifications of for those DNS related records. Okay, then it tells you that it is like system with this much criticality doesn't have any login credential means it is going to affect you. Means someone attackers, if he gets into your system, if he can scans a system using Nmap or any other tools, and if he identifies one system IP address, okay, then if he goes there and if he tries to, like, just imagines if it is, it might be having a username of admin, okay, then what he'll do, he will enter the admin, but because it is not, the username is not an admin, so what he'll do, he will just take a remote desktop connection and he'll just enter the IP address and he'll just click connect. Since there is no IP address and password for it, it will directly go and log into the system. Now your entire DNS and your domain controller means all the systems are controlled using this main machine, doesn't have system credentials itself. Okay, so you, even though all the systems have credentials, okay, what domain controller can do? Domain controller can control any machine that is connected to it. Okay, that much powerful it is. For that only, if the credentials are, it happened many times that people, for some purposes, they might have removed the credentials or they have installed and they might have forgotten. You might be having thousands of assets, one or two. Such things might happen, but if you get this particular event, then you will be immediately identifying that which is that asset and you are containing the machine until it is properly updating with some kind of credentials. Okay, for that purpose it will be used. Okay, then why? So we are monitoring. Okay, it is not some kind of alert or anything, we are trying to continuously monitor. Okay, 1102. Okay, 1102. Okay, the audit log was cleared. So now attacker has come in. So what he has done? He has deleted all the logs, event logs. Okay, for doing that also, if he does that also, an event ID gets generated. Even if he tries to, n number of times he tries to clear, right, that n number of times it will create one more log. Okay, so he, at least if he clears all the logs, one log will be there. That is called as audit 1102. It will get created until, unless he, even if he logs out, at least one log will be there. That will intimate it to the SOC team if they are monitoring it. Okay, monitoring, okay, it, then they will come to know, oh, someone has cleared the log. Why they have cleared the log? Then you will go and check the system. And then you will start investigating what happened to that. Okay. So then you will see what is the criticality of the system. Is that any lateral movement happened? How you will come to know? You will again open some network logs, like some router logs or switch logs, what that user has done. Okay. When he started the initiation of the connection. All those things you will be doing it. So till here, everything is clear for you guys, what I am explaining. Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Is it okay? Let me update my time. I don't know what is the time.
The 11 o'clock.
It's 11. I have to attend that. Okay. We'll see you tomorrow. Okay. It's already 11, I guess. Huh? Guys. Okay.
Yeah.
So just I'll just share these. Yeah, I'll just share these two links, or else you'll be able to get it, right? SOFELK. Okay, GitHub. Just go to, I'll give this. Okay. Only don't look into all the files. You'll get confused. Okay. I would request, you don't need to look into everything. I would request, don't get confused. See the links which I've shared. That's enough for you. Okay, if you look into other aspects, that doesn't going to help you. Instead, it will put, what is this, these things we are going to do every day, I don't know what all these things are there. So that confusion might happen. I would request you don't do that. Okay, fine. Okay, then see you guys. I'll meet you tomorrow. For now, I'll be moving to a meeting. Bye. Take care.
Bye, Agos.